my name is Lizzy and I'm a Girl Scout senior. Today I'm going to show you multiple different ways to dry your own herbs. The first thing you are going to want to do is snip some of your herbs. And make sure when you are snipping your herbs that you leave enough stem at the bottom so you can hang some of them. And I am going to place mine on a tray and label it so that I know which herbs are which when I bring them back inside. First, I am going to cut some of parsley, followed by sage, oregano, basil, and mint. So now that I have cut all the herbs that I would like to dry, I'm going to evaluate them to make sure that they don't have any bugs or weeds mixed in with them, and then I'm going to rinse off the ones that need rinsing, and then we can start the herb drying process. Now that I have inspected, washed, and dried my herbs, it is time to start drying them. The first method I'm going to show you is how to air dry them. This method is best for low moisture plants such as oregano, dill, and rosemary. For the air drying method, you will need paper bags, scissors, string, and a marker. The first thing you are going to want to do is get a bundle of dill, about 4 or 5 stalks of it, and put it all into a bundle together. Now you are going to want to take your paper bag and open it up. I'm also going to dry off my herbs just a little bit more to make sure that they are completely dry. Now I'm going to place them inside, making sure that I leave a little bit of stem at the top, and close the bag. Now I'm going to take my string and tie around the bag. Cutting it so that it leaves enough room so that I can hang it still. Now I'm going to want to take my scissors and make nice big holes in the paper bag for ventilation. You don't want to cut any holes on the bottom of your bag so that in case the herbs dry off or dry and fall off, then they won't fall out of the bag. You want to open the holes with your fingers so that they're nice and big. Is I'm going to write dill on the side of the bag so that I know which herb this is. There we go. Now all you have to do is hang this in a well-ventilated room for about a week until the herbs dry. It has been about a week since I hung these up. It's time to check and see if they are nice and dry and crumbly. The first thing I'm going to do is cut open the bag with my scissors and then I'm going to take out the herb and see if it crumbles nice and easily. This does not crumble as very easily right now, so I think that it needs to get more time to dry. So I'm going to put this back in my bag and hang it up for about another week. I'm also going to check my oregano. I did two methods of drying my oregano. I did one in a paper bag and one outside of a paper bag. The downside of doing this outside of a paper bag is that after it dries, it could fall and it gets dusty if you leave it for more than a week. So So this one is not quite dry yet, so I'm going to have to hang this back up as well. And for the oregano in the bag, I'm going to pull it out. And this is not dry and crumbly either. So I'm going to have to hang up all of these again for about another week or a couple days. So now that my herbs have been drying for a total of 3 weeks now, I'm going to check them again and see if they are dry. My herbs are nice and dry, so now I'm going to put them into a mason jar and label it with what the herb is and when I dried it on. The next process I am going to show you is how to oven dry your herbs. You can also do this process in a dehydrator. This process is best for higher moisture content herbs such as basil, chives, or mint. I am using mint for this process, and you're going to want to place your leaves or seeds of the herb onto a cookie sheet and place them less than an inch deep. Next, you're going to want to place this into an oven that is less than 180 degrees Fahrenheit for about 2 to 4 hours or until the leaves crumble easily. So although it's only been an hour since I put these in the oven, I decided to check them, and they were nice and crumbly like this. So now I'm going to use a scoop to put them into a reused jar that I had. And make sure you don't crush them until you are ready to use them. So now I'm going to put the lid on, and I made a nice label for mine that says what the herb is and when I dried it on. The next method I'm going to show you is the freezer method. This method is best for basil, chives, dill, mint, oregano, parsley, rosemary, sage, and thyme. I'm using parsley for this. And I'm going to pull off the leaves and chop it very well, like I would do for a recipe. Now I'm going to put it in a bag that I have written the amount of parsley that I put in here, what it is, and when I made this. Now you're going to want to seal it very tight and make sure that you have gotten all of the air out. Now, all you have to do is put it in the freezer and pull it out whenever you would like to use it.